everybody out there in virtual land. Come on, let's give him a praise. Praise. And you clap in your hands. But let's praise him. Praise him in the sunshine. Yes. Hallelujah. 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 You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The Lord is good and he's worthy to be praised. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. And it's so good to have you here. Situated in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, all of you that are here in person, and to those of you that are listening virtually by Marco Polo, Facebook, YouTube, God is still in the saving business, regardless of the experiences that we have observed. He is to be praised. His name is to be praised. And it is so good to be in this place called holiness. Amen. Without it, follow peace and holiness with all men, without which no man can see the Lord Jesus Christ. We're just so thankful that you're here. We have taken a virtual break for the last 2 weeks, and I just couldn't wait to get here in person. It's good to be able to praise the Lord virtually, but it's also wonderful to be able to praise God in person. God is good, and we're so happy about it. I want you to get your Bibles very quickly. We are starting a series on the book of Revelation, and hopefully for the next several weeks, we'll be going through Revelation and tying down those areas that would be relative to New Day appearances. And I want you to look at Revelation chapter number 1, and you heard during Bible study our retort and our expression, those of you that were connected to Bible study on this past Wednesday, and also with our midday conference. I encourage you, if you have some time during the noonday, and we're generally on for about a half an hour from about 12 to 12:30, and we commence at about 12:05 in the teaching, praying, praising, testimony, that if you have the opportunity during your lunch hour on Wednesdays to join us during that conference call, you can go to our website and ascertain that toll-free number and the conference call access number to be a part of a group of people that are praying, fasting, and looking toward the Lord. And of course, those of you who were not able to hear via Facebook because we were not in person this past week, but we thank God for Pastor Bates and great preaching on the last Sunday, and a good word. And yes, you can give them a praise. Just a wonderful diatribe of information with spirit. And we're thankful that we have leaders that are literate in the Bible, and the this is a biblicist-centered church on scripture and the understanding of the scriptures as they have been given to us. I want you to set your heart to heaven because of the wonderful things that we are seeing. And for many, it may be frightening, but all of the signs point toward the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And as we gather ourselves and prepare ourselves, the Bible says, look up, for our redemption draweth nigh. If you have Revelations chapter 1, verse 10, and we'll also go through Revelations chapter number 2, I would encourage you, those that are here and those that are in virtual land, to get your notebook, your pencil, your pen, and begin to record some of the notes so that you can return to the pieces of scripture when you have time during the week and study it. We're going to attempt to go through the book of Revelations, the entire book, as it then relates to the body of Christ. The book of Revelation, it was never written for the world. It was written for the body of Christ. The entire chapter is called The Revelation of Jesus Christ. That's really what the book of Revelation is about. It is about the impending refusal of man to repent and turn toward God. Satan and his attempt to take the world hostage, but it also deals with God's people, and then it deals with the rewards of those of us who are living safe in today's land. The book of Revelations promises us there is going to be a new heaven and a new earth, for the old heaven and the old earth have passed away. Revelations chapter number 21 truly speaks about a new Jerusalem descending from heaven. And so we're going to go through the series of events that shall take place in the time to come. And, you know, we are living in, of course, a new year, about to end the first month of 2022. And this is the year 2022 is prophetic. It is actually the year 5782 in Hebrew years. And so we are coming so very close to, and I think I've explained to you all that every 2,000 years, some great cataclysmic event, or escapation, something of a global nature occurs within the earth. We have the creation, and then we have the great Atlantic flooding. We have the judgment of Sodom and Gomorrah. We then have the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, which was seismic according to the word. And the next event to occur that close. When I say that close, not to the ending of time, but now we're living in the beginning of the end that the Bible talks about, speaks about in Matthew chapter number 4, because we're seeing the characteristics of what's going on right here in the United States. I'm going to attempt to connect CRT. I'm going to connect January 6th. I'm going to connect our new governor and the platform of the Democrats, the platform of the Republicans. And for many of you who were thinking that Biden was going to be an answer to all of our problems, but that will never happen. It will never happen. And if we are to be quite truthful at this particular time, he has appeared to be a very weak president. And it is alarming, no more alarming than our previous president. And you all know clearly that I'm neither Republican nor Democrat. I am for the word of the Lord. And I'm on a side on the word of the Lord and the scripture. And the scripture is telling us of what is about to transpire. I want to pray because many of you have read this past week that whoever reads the book of Revelation receives a blessing. And those that hear and obey the word of the Lord, according to the book of Revelation, will receive a blessing. I don't know about you, but I need a blessing right now. I need a blessing. And I'm not talking about money, cars, and homes. I'm not talking about a new position and a new title. And that I want to be happy in Jesus. The Bible states a peace that passes all understanding. I want a peace, desire a peace that passes beyond my comprehension. Now that's the media team to put together on the screen. I would like for you to watch the screen to the left, the screen to the right. And I believe I shared some of this with those of you via text on last week. But I want you to see how close and how realistic we are to the coming of the Lord. And I believe this YouTube pick is just a few moments, because we are living in the moment right now where the rapture can take place. So, media team, if you look to your left or to your right of the video that we're about to play as we prepare ourselves for the word of the Lord.
Oh, shit.
what you just saw was a depiction, because we don't know quite exactly how it's going to occur. But before the son of perdition, the Antichrist, is to be revealed, and he cannot be totally revealed until this next event occurs. What is seen on the YouTube is what the New Testament saints believe to be the next great event to occur, which is the rapture. And I use the YouTube to display the church, because many people attend church, but the church is not in them. And it doesn't matter what church you attend. And people say, well, I know the Lord. The problem is not with you knowing the Lord. It's whether the Lord knows you. And Matthew's chapter number 5, we're dealing with eschatology, the coming prophecies. And so it's in that Matthew's chapter number 5 where people at the judgment will approach God at the great white throne, and they will say, we fed in your name, we clothed in your name, we visited those in prison in your name. Then the Bible says he's going to turn his head, and turning of the head Hebraically means rejection. And he says, depart from me, for I know you not. Now, how could it be that God that created you didn't know you? It's not that he isn't visible to what we think, do, and say. The fact of the matter is, there was something hidden from God. Not that anything can be hidden, but there was a hiding, just as Adam and Eve hid themselves from God when they fell and ate of the forbidden fruit. They clothed themselves because they recognized that they were naked. And God asked Adam, where are you? Now, how could Adam or Eve hide anywhere in Eden where God's eyes could not see? It wasn't that they were physically hiding. It is spiritually something happened that broke the relationship, the union, the fellowship between Adam and Eve. Something broke. They used to have connection, but somehow something interfered with their relationship. And though they were in Eden, God said, where are you? And then his second question was, what is it that you have done? Where are you? And what have you done that could or has separated you from the relationship of God? And so as you saw on the television, many will be in church and miss the rapture. Many will be attending church somewhere. We don't know the hour or the time when the Lord shall appear. But there will be people in church, and immediately the sound of Christ, those that are saved, shall hear a trumpet sound, and within a 1,000th of a 1,000th of a second, a change will take place. That's where we are right now. And when I say we're close, we are that close. Because the Bible in Matthew's chapter number 24 tells us that before he appears, the gospel is going to be preached to every basket, every region, every place. Where is the place that the World Wide Web cannot connect to in the world? And could it be the plan, even during this time of separating and distancing, that the body of Christ had to go underground? The body of Christ went virtual so that the gospel is saturated on the internet. I know there are a lot of things that we watch on the internet, but it's impossible to preview the internet and not hear the gospel.
Amen.
And now there is no excuse. Well, I don't like the Crystal. I don't like First Baptist. I don't like St. John's. I don't like the way he preaches. I don't like the way she preaches. I don't like the way they do things. God said, you cannot escape the gospel. Because every man, every woman, every boy, girl, whether you're blind, whether you're deaf, have an opportunity to accept the Lord Jesus Christ. We are now living in a season where Jesus is telling us all, repent, for the Son of Man is about to appear. What will we say to God when we've had many times to repent and be saved and baptized, but we blamed it on the preacher, we blamed it on this, we blamed it on that, we blamed it on the church was boring. Jesus is going to say, I gave you a chance. After chance, after chance, after chance. Even if you didn't go to the church, you heard it on the radio, you heard it on your computer, you heard it on the telephone.
Amen.
Repent, which means turn away from your wicked sin. I want to tell you today, you can't save you, and neither can I save you. There needs to be a God that's holy, that's righteous, the perilous of sin, that can wash you in the blood. Because what can wash away your sin? You have a time right now to repent and say, Lord, wash me. Wash my mind, my mouth. Wash my filthy thoughts and attitudes. Because I can't take it to heaven. I can't make the rapture without the Holy Ghost. You can put your head down and ignore it. But God is going to pull up the screen in heaven, and you're going to have to give an account of the word you receive. That's why I can't be your friend. I can't be your ace poop cool. I can't be your lottie body, because your soul is at stake. Eternal life with God or eternal life in damnation is at stake. Bible says, the day you hear my voice, don't you say, I can do it next week. I can do it tomorrow. Let me put this down. Let me put that down. The Lord said, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart, because I'm calling you to make a decision. Look at your neighbor and say, today the Lord is calling you to make a decision. And only you can make the decision. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Somebody ought to give God the praise. If you've been washed in the blood, you've been filled with the Holy Ghost, God has made you rich. Hallelujah. We are so close. We are so, so close. I was talking to a young person early this morning and just encouraging them, get it right with Christ. Because in the past, it was old people that were dying. Guess what? Young folk are dying now. At the millions. I'm not just talking about COVID. But I'm just having heart attacks, being stressed out. You don't know, and I don't know, when the Lord should call us home. And you don't have to be my age or older. God is calling people into eternity. Do you have the book of Revelations? I want you to turn with me, chapter number 1. And for the sake of time, I want to commence reading at verse number 10. And we'll read verse number 10 throughout, and then go into chapter number 2. And what I hope to give you today is an explanation of 5782 in the Greek years 2022. What I believe will occur 2022. We're going to see some events that are going to hasten us to the rapture. And he can't be revealed until we get out of here. And thank God for that. Because you're going to read some things, the atrocities that are going to take place. If you think folk are fighting each other now, if you think the mask issue is a major issue that's separating the United States, we are about to step into what is called martial law. And we're being programmed now for the mark of the beast. Did you hear what I said? We are being programmed to take the mark of the beast. Are you ready for the word of the Lord? Let's pray. Father, help us in Jesus' name. Amen. I want Scott to come. So if you come, and if you read Revelation chapter 1, commencing at verse number 10, and I want you to please to read silently with him as we begin to understand the word of the Lord. Please don't be disturbed. If you hear a different translation other than the King James Version, we have the King James Version, but for your comprehension and to understand what is going to transpire, you may hear the King James, you may hear the English Version, contemporary version, as I was reading this week, Revelation chapter 1, verse number 10 to the conclusion of that chapter. Please read.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord. This is the NIV version, as Bishop has stated, starting in chapter 10, Revelations 1. On the Lord's day, I was in the Spirit. I heard behind me a loud voice, it was like a trumpet, which said, write on a scroll what you see and send it to the seven churches, Ephesus, Samaria, Pergamum, Thyatira, Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea. I turned to see the voice that was speaking to me, and when I turned, I saw seven gold lampstands, and among the lampstands were some like some men dressed in a robe, reaching down to his feet with a golden sash around his chest. His head and his hair were white like wool and white as snow, and his eyes were like blazing fire. His feet were bronze, glowing in a furnace, and his voice was like the sound of a rushing waters. And in his right hand he held 7 stars, and out of his mouth came a sharp, double-edged sword. His face was like the sun shining in all of its brilliance. And when I saw him, I fell at his feet as though dead. Then he placed his right hand on me and said, "Do not be afraid. I am the first and the last. I am the living one. I was dead, and behold, I'm alive forever and ever. I hold the keys of death and Hades. Write, therefore, before what you have seen, what is now and what will take place later, and the mystery of the 7 stars that you saw in my right hand, and of the 7 gold lampstands. This is the 7 stars that are angels, and the 7 churches, and the 7 lampstands are the 7 churches."
The goal was to have John recant, or to say, "I don't know the Lord."
Yeah.
If you recall that one of the tests that Peter failed was when he was under pressure, he recanted his testimony. What I mean by recant: when Jesus was taken in the Garden of Gethsemane, that night there were people that recognized Peter and said, "Peter, aren't you one of his disciples? Aren't you one of the persons who followed?" Peter cursed and said, "I don't know the man. I don't know anything about him." And Peter knew that if he wouldn't stand that night, that he too would be killed. So one of the questions is, how will you respond to pressure in your life? Everybody's under pressure now. People are afraid of testing positive. People are afraid of dying. People are not sure whether to mask or unmask. Do we push the January 6th controversy? What will happen in 2022? What will happen in 2023? Is the Senate race? And what's going to happen to the church? We saw nearly a year ago the evangelicals taking a political stance, prophesying that our previous president was going to win. And that didn't happen yet. Didn't happen yet. And so there is great pressure, and it is satanic influence that's trying to tell the world
that the church is fake. The power of the Holy Ghost is fake. Folk that have been saved, the redemptive power of Christ is fake. And because of it, many have left church despondent. My God. They've left despondent because there were folk who were standing in good times proclaiming Jesus. But when they were under pressure, they cried. Hallelujah. I'm seeing more folk backslide than I ever have in my 40 years of being saved. Folk that I would never think that would take down. God has been so good for them, to them, with them. I would have never dreamt that they would turn their back. But we are living in a season now. There is so much satanic influence that it has entered the church place. Hallelujah.
Make it plain.
So much to the point. Amen. We gotta have a band. We gotta have majestic music. People have to scream and holler to yell just for people to get in the spirit. And singing don't put you in the spirit. It's the word. The Bible says, and they will not endure sound doctrine. For don't like to be, don't want to be corrected. Everybody is right. Nobody has to repent. And I can give my opinion and not have to show my face. But I heard the word say, let God be strong, and let every man be a liar. Hallelujah. And it's not what you do when great things happen for you. It is when you are under great pressure. Enemies trying to get you to stop worshiping. Hallelujah. As good as God has been to you, He wants you to close your mouth. Close the book. Don't come to church. But I tell you, God has been too good to me. And God has been so good to you that if nobody comes to church, I'll come. If nobody will praise Him, I'll lift my voice and say hallelujah. And somebody give God a praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
What are you going to do? Don't let me fail you. All that you brought me were sick and you were broke and you lost your mind, and I kept you in the hollow of my hand. Don't you give up now. Don't you stop looking for the Holy Ghost. Don't you stop seeking His face. Oh, somebody praise Him in the house. Hallelujah. What will you do?
But you won't pray.
got the rest of this month to deal with this.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Don't quit God now. Don't you become discouraged. God's got you.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the midst of your storm, you are not walking alone. And if the truth be known, all of us are going through. And you're going through as much as you can take, and I'm going through as much as I can take. But the trouble is revealing the Christ inside. The hope of glory. He's our hope. From a backslide. I was talking to a preacher, finished for today. I was talking to a preacher this week who just left the church. Had become so distressed, lost his job, lost family members, lost his home, lost members in the church that he is pastoring. And he said, Maurice, I have nothing to live for. He said, I've given my entire life, my adult life, and 65, my entire life to the Lord. And he's going to leave me like this. And he felt that the things that he was going through, that it was Jesus' fault because he wanted to torment him. And I'm listening to him cry because he lost his focus. What you're going to see next week, we did get into chapter number 2. Jesus speaks to the churches. He saw 7 candles, 7 stars, 7 angels. 7 angels are the 7 pastors of the 7 churches that we're going to talk about in chapter number 2. Candles, and the candles that represent 7 churches. The 7 spirits, we're going to talk about what are the 7 spirits of the Word of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
7 spirits. And for the 7 spirits of God, there are 7 demons that come. Change from culture to climate. You're going to see some climatic things coming. And those of you that are aware, off of the West Coast, a seismic earthquake in the specific. And you're going to see some earthquakes. I believe we will see in 2022 earthquakes in diverse places. The earth itself is going to shake. I believe we will see tsunamis. The second thing is we're going to see an economic downturn. It's already here. The question with the government is when they're going to increase the percentage of inflation, deflation, the interest rates. And are they going to change the interest rates in the first quarter, the second quarter, the first 3 months of 2022? It's already been broadcast that in 2021, they were looking for a stock market crash in 2021. They did not happen. It may happen in 2022. Keep your eye on Israel. Three things. You're going to see Israel and Iran go to war. We may see Israel bomb Iran because of Iran's development of the nuclear bomb. Number two, we're seeing it right before our eyes. China is ready to invade Taiwan. America has an agreement with Taiwan that if China provokes a disturbance, that America will come to the aid of Taiwan. And Taiwan is right off of the coast of China. China is telling America, we dare you to intervene. And ships are being assembled as we speak in the China Sea for a showdown. Because America is saying, if you invade Taiwan and strip her of her rights, we will have to intervene. And China's saying, if you do, there will be war. The Bible speaks of wars and rumors of wars. The third rumor of war is Russia. And some of her provocative natures gets Afghanistan. Pakistan. And Russia, I'm trying to remember the country right now, they would come to where it's poised to take control of another region, and America's being stretched. While we're still battling critical race theory, we talk about masks here in America.
When Jesus comes, will you be ready?
God and